teacher that supervised me in different committees with that committee. Thank you very much. I'm the second director of the volunteer program. I'm here tonight to talk about volunteerism. Each of us volunteers in our lives in some way, with our family, with our friends, at schools, at community gatherings, at festivals, at fundraisers. We all appreciate what volunteerism does. A volunteer, Victoria, volunteers are brought to about 295 member agencies. As we know, the community has had a lot of demands on this. Non-profit organizations are being asked to help the community in ways that they never have before. The demands are higher, and they're different, and they're open to them. So in addition to volunteers who mentor children, who visit schools, who go to hospitals, we're being asked for volunteers with very specific skills: strategic planning, governance, fundraising, operations, social media, sponsorships, networking. And the call for volunteers is wider and greater. A volunteer, Victoria, we're committed to building leadership capacity in the nonprofit sector. Last year, 800 people registered for leadership opportunities. This February, 59 board members from over 30 different nonprofits participated in board training. How do we help the community smarter, faster, ahead of the trends, and be just more efficient, more effective, and more engaged in supporting the future? Our goal is to help nonprofits with their best.
trucks going through the store lot can be a real challenge. The sounds, the lights on the street, they can get frozen. They have to, I've had people tell me I have to walk on the side of the buildings so that I don't lose my way. Their brains work so hard, they fall asleep. They say they wake up and find themselves sitting on somebody's front doorstep asleep because they were so tired. They have difficulty with focus, and their
start off by saying that the film industry brings in $1.2 billion of direct spending into the economy in BC every single year. Our Office of the Film Commission, we spend a lot of time and effort to try to both increase that number and to increase the number in general for all of BC, but more importantly, to bring a bigger piece of that pie to the CRD. And we've been very successful in spite of some of some really big challenges over the years, including the economic downturn and our exclusion from the 6% distant tax credit and a few other challenges that we've had. But last year we managed to bring in 22 projects into the Greater Victoria area, everything from the Cupcake Girls to Dragon's Den to the story of J.K. Rowling, to a fairly large movie called Big Time Movie, and a whole lot of other small commercials and productions that we were instrumental in bringing into the area. We also did a lot of work with our local Indigenous producers in helping a lot of young people make their very first movie last year. We helped Victoria Westcott bring her movie called Locked in a Garage Band, very, very low budget, but to fruition, a great little movie, as well as some of the bigger local producers, including Karen Davies of Cedarwood Productions. Some of you may know her, some of her television shows, including Flavors of the West Coast. We help these Indigenous producers every day of the week with locations and other support around tax incentives and tax credits and that sort of thing. We sent out over 70 packages last year, ranging from low budgets to big Hollywood features like Superman and The Company of King. Unfortunately, we're not able to land all of them, mainly just because we don't have the location that we have, certainly not for lack of trying. Last year we also fielded many, many requests for crew, accommodations, tax credit, as I mentioned. We did a dozen location surveys and fan tours, bringing new producers into our area and showing them around and showing some of the beautiful locations that we have both in Saanich and in the CRD. We held many events last year, both to help the film community get together, mixers, and seminars for local businesses, including our very popular Doing Business with the Film Industry seminar that we put on every year for local business owners to help them cash in on some of the opportunities available in our industry. As well as we go around and talk to students and help them understand what it takes to be a technician in the industry, working behind the camera and in front of the camera. We have a seminar coming up on Thursday, registering your home or your property as a location. So we will try to hold that once a year so that people can understand how they can register with us their home and their property and their business as a film location. So that's coming up on Thursday. We do all of that. We do trade shows in LA where we take beautiful photographs of all of our locations down to trade shows such as Locations Expo, which is a big expo of location film commissioners from around the world that set up big venue in LA, and producers come through and visit all of us and take home our literature. So that's just some of the work we do, and of course, none of it is possible without the support of Saanich and Victoria and most of the local municipalities. So thank you for your time.
Thank you. Very quickly, we have the your financial statements here ended until 2010. Do you have the 2011?
We're still waiting for that coming back from the auditors. We're hoping it will be back by the end of the month. So as soon as we get it, I'll make sure that you get that.
Appreciate that.
So, there's many partnerships. We have local artists, which will have, this will be the major outlet for the year. We have, the last show we had five, we have five waiting for this show. And, it's a yearly event, and for this year we have another five artists. We're actually hoping to get up to 10, and this is one of the ways that they really expose themselves to the community. We also have many local societies and clubs which really don't have any kind of partnership or relationship with the community at all. This is their major exposure. We have a local coin society. We have a stamp collecting society, a postcard club. Just about anything, you name it, and the club is there. The idea of Vimax was to be a show of shows so that you wouldn't just go to a hockey card show. You would go to Vimax because the hockey card show would be there, the comic book show would be there, and every kind of collecting show would be there, as well as many things like Big Brothers and Sisters who will actually be there introducing themselves and what they're doing in this city.
this just happened to be a little more visible. I always refer to our services as being invisible because when you see our clients and their constituents out of the community, it looks like what it is, a neighbor helping a neighbor. This last year, we followed our strategic plan diligently, and we did client surveys and volunteer surveys. The volunteer surveys were digital electronic, and we were thrilled to find that 98.5% of our volunteers felt extremely satisfied with the work they were doing with our agency. And that, of course, is why we have some of the best volunteer retention in the region. Further, in the fall, we did a mail-out survey to our clientele, a sample, and we found that 96% of the clients were extremely happy with value and the service that they were receiving. The most important piece, though, is the feedback that we received, the anecdotal comments that we asked our clientele to provide. And I think it's really important that we receive that direct feedback as well, because it goes to you as well. So here's the kinds of things that clients say. Able to get to the doctors and other appointments, especially to Saanich Peninsula Hospital to visit my husband before he passed away. All of you are wonderful and caring and patient. I have difficulty walking and the volunteers help me get in and out of the car and to my appointments. So, irreplaceable taxi drivers. When I have to go to an appointment in a new location, it is wonderful knowing someone from SVSS will be here to assist me. You make growing older so much less stressful. Every one of us in the room is going to be there one day. Good for everyone. I have more, but I think that this one really says it all. Without SVSS, I would sit at home alone. No visitors, no phone calls. They are the answer to a prayer and make my life worth living. Why, Cypher will motivate me to keep fundraising and coming to talk to you every year. Take a minute and imagine what this community would be like without all of these worthy causes that you're hearing from tonight, and in particular, of course, Saanich volunteers and the great group of people that we collaborate with at Volunteer Victoria and its Good Services. Saanich Recreation Centers, they're everywhere in Saanich. Any questions for me tonight?
Thank you. In your budget, I notice an increase in salaries. Last year, from 2010 to 2011, there was about a $20,000 increase, and this year an additional $6,000. Is that a direct staff members, or is that actually an increase for the existing?
Thank you for that question. We actually had a reduction in staff salaries as a result of the cut the year before. That was 15% reduction. What you're seeing now in the increase in salaries is a change in budgeting practice. We have one employee on a separate contract with VHOC up until the year before last, when we combined the two contracts into one. So prior, it was shown as a community services contract, and she's now included as an employee.
applications from the Brisbane Lake, which is this community. And one of a board of nine people that have taken on the responsibility to maintain the weir at the mouth of the lake going down to Torquay. The annual grant of $3,500 remains the same. We are a volunteer group. We have no other fundraising activity around this group. We do involve ourselves with other fundraising initiatives, particularly with the Brisbane Lake Preservation Society, which is linked to the health of the knowledge of the lake. We have some concerns there. We are going to be working with them. We're actually talking to Cleo out of Sydney. They're a biologist group. One of the problems we have is not just the fishery window. The Fish Department of Fisheries say where the fishery window is when you're going to do any work around the stream. That's where we're involved with them. We're also working with Adrian Pollard from the Environment Department. We're also working with the Friends of Toad Creek in a gentle way. They have some other remediation work that they do. So our job is to maintain the weir as best as we can. And it seems to be integrated into the whole ecosystem around there. And what we're noticing is on the downstream and upstream side, there's a lot of debris accumulated from 4 years ago. There was a lot of windrow, and the willows have grown up such that the weir does not flow clear. That means that if that was the weir there, it's on the downstream side, it forms as a pool. So now the material that's coming from the lake is settling down such that we know that we need to do some repair to the repairing area. So LG now have seen the next months in stream bed restoration and stream bed repair. The problem is
wide variety of subjects of interest to the community. Last year, Gallery hosted 16,000 visits. We are continually looking to develop new programs for our members to expand our events and programs within the community at large. Another factor that makes Gallery most unique is our beautiful location. This makes the facility very attractive for special events, particularly summer weddings. We have been able to augment our operating funds through revenue
costs. And we program the partnership with the community society in terms of the we're also working on community investment from the proposal with a number of stakeholders in the region to create a vehicle for people to place retirement and investment savings in ways that can then be used to contribute to invest in affordable rental housing as well as community enterprises. And then finally, under our community economic pillar, we're working on a peninsula agriculture economic strategy, which has been funded initially by the district of North Saanich, in which we now have stakeholders from across agricultural business interests wanting to move that strategy forward. In fact, we just sent off the invitation to members of council and planning staff here at Saanich to attend the presentation that the other municipalities invited to. In addition to our community economic with the real estate board of Redmond Victoria and supported by the Real Estate Foundation BC, working on a strategy around trying to create, to enable and create tools that incentive the development of additional apartment rentals to contribute to affordable housing. The planning department here at District of Newport is to participate in some of the work like that. And then we're also working on a youth housing strategy to address some of the housing issues around young people who are in vulnerable housing circumstances. Community sustainability work is mainly focused around food security, building a sustainable food and agriculture system, and we have a new program there which is trying to link up organizations, businesses that are willing to donate healthy food with the charitable food provision agencies to create a more efficient and integrated system for food banks and other emergency programs. And then finally, our area is around community action on poverty. We have a working group that's called Doing It Better Together, to try to bring all of the agencies together to create a strategy and action plan to address those aspects of poverty prevention and action. We have some local control over how we individually work better together and provide the tools for people to prevent themselves from getting into poverty and to get out of poverty. And those are the main pillars of the work that we're asking you for support to. We've asked for the same amount as last year, with a small increase for inflation, the 2% request, which all of the core municipalities council have submitted with the same request. I think it's the first time we've asked for any increase in many years. And just on the budget, we should mention that we didn't get the gaming board, so we're another one of those agencies that weren't successful. We haven't received one for some time, so it's a surprise. But that will mean on the expenditure side, our personnel costs will increase as much as was indicated in the general budget. And our financial year runs from April to March, so we won't have our audited statements in the current fiscal year until after we have our year end in April. So, welcome any questions that the council may have.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So, the loss of the game grant is presumably less expansion.
It means that the one FTE that we were hoping to create to run the food access program that I mentioned, Give Food, Get Food, we won't be able to create that additional staffing position. We have received a small grant from VEHA, which means that we'll be able to use a mix of volunteer and subcontractors.
Sure. And the increase in personnel that was projected was primarily that FTE?
Yes, there is one additional FTE that is funded by a two-year grant by the Horner Foundation, and that FTE we will be able to implement.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, Mayor and Member of Council. Thank you for the opportunity to come and present this evening. My name is Carol Thompson, Ladies Cup from the Cedar Hill Golf Club. The Cedar Hill Golf Club Ladies
sign of our appreciation for your support last year. And I know it says municipality of Saanich. I should have put district of Saanich.
Yeah.